Hey everyone, my name's Braden. We're going to go over how to iterate or loop over a Pandas data frame. There are many ways that we can loop over a data frame. We'll first go over the most intuitive way of doing this. However, this way is not as efficient as some other methods that are available to us. These additional methods don't add much more complexity, but they can give us a huge boost in performance. So stick around to see how you can implement these methods into your own code. To get started, we'll import pandas as pd, and we'll also import numpy. I've already written out a little bit of code to create a data frame. What this code is doing is giving us 10,000 rows and 5 columns of random floats between 0 and 1. We are naming our columns A, B, C, D, and E. Let's use df.describe to check out our data frame in a little more detail. So we see that the mean is pretty close to 0.5. That's what we'd expect. The minimum is very close to 0, and the maximum is very close to 1, with 10,000 rows for each column. So to get started, we'll use for I, comma row in df.iterrows. This is the first method that's available to us to iterate over all the rows in a data frame. So what this does is return the index, that's I, and the row of data, that's row. And for demonstration purposes, I've already written out a little bit of code. This code will print out the first 3 iterations, and it will show us I, the index, and then the returned row. And then if we want to specify just a single value or from a column, then we'll do that here. So we can say row and then the column that we are calling. So here we see the first iteration, the index is 0, then 1, and then 2. It prints out the entire row's data, and then the value for that row and that column that we specified. To show this a little more clearly, we can compare it to our data frame head. So you can see for this last one here, index 2, if we look at index 2, that this data matches up here, A, 0.47, and so forth. So most of the time, we don't want to just print out the values. We want to actually do something with that. So we can create a function. We'll call it iterRowExample. And we'll pass it the data frame and the column. And we'll say for I row in df.iterrows. We'll store the value. So we'll call the row and the column. And if that value is less than 0.5, we'll say we want to change that to equal 0. So what I've done here is use the dot at method on our data frame and said at index, whatever the index is here in the df iterrows, and at the column here, the column that we specify, so it might be at index 1 and column B, so it'd give us this value, we want it to equal 0 if it's less than 0.05. Else, df.at I column is equal to 1. So if it's less than 0.5, we'll say it's 0. If it's greater than or equal to 0.5, we'll say it's 1. We'll use a magic method called timeit. What this does is shows us the amount of time that it takes to run that line of code. So we're going to call our function that we just made, pass it df, that's our data frame, and we'll say we want these changes to be made on column A. And let's run that. So it took 528 milliseconds to run this command. Now that seems fast, however, I know we can do much better. In fact, we can copy this code above and just make a few little changes and make it run even faster. So let's call this iloc example. We'll use the .iloc method. Once again, we'll pass in the data frame and the column. We're not going to use iterrows anymore, but we will use .index. And we don't have access to rows anymore because we are only using index instead of iterrows. What we can do here is say df call dot iloc and then give the index position. So what this is doing is for the column that we passed in, it's finding the value at index location I. And then all of this can be the same. So with those few changes, let's see what kind of performance boost we can get. We'll pass in our data frame, and this time we'll say column B. We'll run that, and I forgot to run this cell above, so we'll do that real quick. Run it again. So we get 170 milliseconds. So with just those few little changes, we get a 3x speed increase, which is pretty good. But we can do even better. This time what we'll do is we'll use the apply method. So we just need one line of code here. And we'll say df column C is equal to df column C dot apply lambda x is going to equal 0 if x is less than 0.5, else set it equal to 1. So lambda functions at first can be a little confusing. I'll put a link in the description below to an explanation of lambda functions. I'll create a video sometime in the near future on that. So let's run this. And we have 3.24 milliseconds. That's a 52x speed increase from our previous record. Can we get any faster? Yes, we can. So instead of using the apply method, what we can do is change up a few little things and use the np.where method. So we'll say df d is equal to np.where. And what we'll do is pass in the condition that we want. So in this case, we want to say where the data frame column D is less than 0.5. And then we give it what we want the value to be if this condition is satisfied. So that would be 0 if it's less than 0.5. And then we say what we want it to be otherwise. So that would be 1. Let's run this. Whew. And we get 207 microseconds. That's 15x faster than our previous record. Nice. And get this, with just a little tweak, we can get even faster. So we'll copy this code from above, and then what we'll say is dot values. So what this does is essentially turn this into a NumPy array. It strips out all the additional overhead that a Pandas series has. So if we run that, we get 92 microseconds. That's amazing. All we had to do is add dot values, and we get over 2x faster performance. So if we compare it to our original iterrows example, that's over 5,700x faster. If you have a small data set that you're working with, it probably doesn't matter that much. However, the larger your data set, the more beneficial doing these minor tweaks will be. The reason we can get such massive gains in performance is, number one, by using methods that have been optimized for speed, so using .apply or np.where, and also through vectorization. In these final two methods, we pass in the entire data frame series, or in this case, an array of values, and the operation is done on that entire entire set of data, rather than in the other cases where we're looping through each single value, we have to perform those operations on each of those values, which is much slower. So the moral of the story is use optimized methods where possible and vectorization. Plus, once you get used to this syntax, it's much easier than writing out all of this code above. So not only is it faster performance-wise, but it also helps us to write our code faster as well. So I would recommend to only use df.iterrow if you have to. Otherwise, it's much more performant to use one of these other methods here. If you have any questions on how you can apply these methods to your specific situation, you can leave a comment down below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And I'll also provide a link to an annotated Jupyter Notebook going over these methods in the description below. Thanks for watching.